Nonprofit group has fought for fair housing in communities across southeast Louisiana, often making headlines, even challenging businesses and local governments in court.
It's brash and sometimes controversial, but the problem of discrimination, its members say, is very real.
And tonight we take you inside a recent investigation that they say illustrates the problem. WDSU reporter Sydney Chuman has this exclusive story.
On the North Shore, the rental notices are all around. In neighborhoods, on the internet, and in the newspaper.
Unfortunately, we found that a significant amount of the time when people of color would try to rent an apartment, they experienced discrimination.
But sometimes, according to James Perry of the Greater New Orleans Fair Housing Action Center, you might not even know it. Using a process called mystery shopping, the center routinely conducts investigations, most recently on the North Shore. They hire two people to try to rent an apartment, one white and one black.
They both have the same degrees, same income, everything is the same except for their race. And so when they go to try to rent an apartment, in theory, they both qualify, and so the landlord should give them the same offer because the only difference is their race.
But that's not always what happens. A day later, at the same St. Tammany apartment, the white person is quoted a lower security deposit.
I told him there was a $200 electric deposit.
And just a $300 down.
Okay. All right.
In a similar case, the white person was offered a rental special.
So what we would do is $7.99. The first month would be free.
However, no mention is ever made to the black person. Sometimes the discrimination is simply a refusal to show the property. Here, the black person arrives, but doesn't get a meeting, and his calls go unanswered. Compare that to the white person, who is actually given the security code to enter the property on his own.
On the front door, there is a keypad.
Okay, for the cottage, yeah.
Okay.
I'm right here.
Okay, yes. Let me think of what the code is.
The discrimination is not blatant, but subtle, which is why Tulane Law Professor Stacy Schecksnyder says audio recordings like these are admissible in court to corroborate fair housing complaints.
I think they're extremely valuable because very often people who are being discriminated against aren't sure that what's happening to them is discrimination. Even the government, for example, the Justice Department, has used audio recordings to conduct investigations to try to gather additional information.
Of the 11 North Shore properties tested, 7 acted in a discriminatory manner, according to Perry. Still, he believes progress has been made.
So the next step is to get people to the point of saying, not only do I think it's a bad thing that I need to hide, but it's so bad that I should not ever do it.
Perry reminds landlords discrimination is more than just unfair. It's illegal. On your side on the North Shore, Simney Chuan, WDSU News.
So now, according to the Department of Housing and Urban Development, 183 fair housing complaints were filed in the state last year. In 2010, 203 complaints were filed.